My name is Mike Dierkes with KE2 ThermSolutions. Today we are going to review the content and features of the KE2 LDA Dashboard and Management Console. First, for those not entirely familiar with the KE2 LDA communication device, it was a huge step forward allowing all KE2 Therm controllers to be remotely monitored and controlled. It also provides the ability to send alarm notifications via text or email. With some contractors having hundreds of KE2 Temp and KE2 Low Temp installs, this is proving to be a huge asset. Basically, up to 10 KE2 Therm controllers that are connected to the KE2 LDA or the same network as the KE2 LDA are displayed on the dashboard. In this diagram, we see 8 KE2 Temps and KE2 Low Temps connected to the KE2 LDA and 2 KE2 Evaps also on the same network. They would all show up on the KE2 LDA dashboard, which looks like this. Across the top, we see endpoints, which for the serial devices like the KE2 Temp show service view. And for the Ethernet controllers like the KE2 Evap, the IP address is displayed. Next is location, which is user-defined to help you identify where each controller is in use. Then we see mode, which is the current operating condition. Then room for the current room temperature. Alarm is next and will display in red if there is an alarm condition. By clicking on the arrow next to logs and picking a date range, it will download and display the data logs for the controller you choose, if you have data log add-on. As a dashboard, it provides a quick snapshot of all the controllers. However, if you click on the device, you are taken to the controller's webpage. Please refer to our other videos that display how to navigate the web pages for each family of controllers. Okay, so let's return to our dashboard. On the top far right of the page, you will see the word manage. Click manage and log in with the management credentials provided on the LDA label. You are now on the management console page. We will focus on the main five features that most people will work with on the management console. First, publishing controllers to KE2 Smart Access. Check the box for access. Enter the site name and password, then select the controllers you want on the KE2 Smart Access site. Two, set up email and text alerts. Check the box to enable alerts. Using the default settings work for most, or use the advanced SMTP to define your own server. Third, in the credentials section, you now have the ability to change the name and password for both the management and Modbus users, as well as the SSID password. Please note that you cannot change the Wi-Fi SSID. Four, under the advanced menu, you have the option to tether the LDA to an existing wireless network. This is designed to be used when physically running cable to the LDA isn't an option. Lastly, there is a button to update the firmware. For more information, please visit our website or contact tech support.